is too many kids playing video games. The planet Dollar Crowbear mentions the best histories for us ahead about the coolest things we've seen teachers do. I'm Dipping, and today I'll be your narrator. Number 10 lesson at home, E4 Epic. When Melissa was in the 4th grade, her and a friend found a baby bird who'd fallen out of its nest near the playground. So they put it on her friend's head and took it to class after recess. When the teacher saw everybody in the class around them, the teacher naturally became suspicious. When she came over and saw Melissa and her friend with the featherless baby bird with 3 twigs and a leaf in her hat, she became upset at first, but then let them give it to her. The next day of class, she had in one of those small plastic pet containers she put hermicrabs in. With pretty legit looking bedding, a small light bulb for warmth, and cloth as a blanket, she made up a class project for everyone to take care of it, and she would take it home with her. A few weeks later, when it had all of its feathers and the teacher had helped it learn how to fly, Melissa and her class had a dollar recess and watched it fly away. They later learned that from its color patterns, it was a starling. Number 9 was submitted by Dina Rowan. Some of the kind of a few cool teachers in high school and in middle school, but there was one that sticks out from the rest. His name was Dr. Owen. He was his 11th grade writer's workshop teacher and his 12th grade AP Lit teacher. He was one of the coolest mofos ever. First off, if you could make a good argument that applies to the entire class, he wouldn't assign homework, although no one ever succeeded. Around the Kylan's 11th grade year, he learned more about Dr. Owen. He found out he has a book published. It's academic stuff, but it's still pretty rare for a high school teacher. Then he found out that Dr. Owen was in a band and was doing solo work. He never performed from the Kylan in his class despite asking. Then, the Kylan did some extracurricular for extra credit. It was like a cool beat poetry night. Then, at the end of it all, Dr. Owen finally played one of his songs. It was way cool. Then after he played a song or two, he said, "I have these lying around, so all this stuff, guys." And now, Mikaela has one of his albums. Number 8 was submitted by Donna Risky. In Ladybug's math class, the phone kept ringing and it was getting really annoying. Especially to her teacher, who was, you know, trying to teach for Pete's sake. There was a test the next day, so he didn't have time for class to keep being interrupted. So he promised that the next time he interrupted her, he would smash it on the floor and break it. He was probably just joking until the phone rang again and he threw it across the room. It was the most beautiful thing Ladybug's class has ever seen. Number 7 was submitted by Jasmine Lily 12. The coolest thing Nick Sion saw a teacher do was throw a book at a student. He was in the 4th grade when they were reading something in their science book, when a kid named Tyler started to act like a little prick. He started to pick out a girl in the middle of him and Nick Sion. Tyler was saying some really mean shit. All of a sudden, the teacher said, "Hey kids, I'm going to show you a demonstration of the law of motion," or something like that, and throw it at Tyler, who was never a little prick again. Number 6 was submitted by Wolfgar. In high school, Halvin had a math teacher. He was always chill and got along with everyone. But there were kids who were dressed in skimpy clothes who were hanging their hands below their ankles. Not that these were the brightest kids you would ever find, and they were ridiculous. After being sent to the office, these kids only got a slap on the wrist and sent back to class. Halvin's teacher had a knack, so he bought a ton of notes, t-shirts, and sweatpants. Every time this student was either dressed like a hoe or a gangster, his teacher would give them a belt, shirt, or sweatpants, and send them to the bathroom. He said, "You can get an F and sit outside, or get changed." That year, Halvin's class got passing grades. Number 5 was submitted by Elson Eck. Taleb's high school history teacher named Mr. Culligan used to be the lead guitarist for a band called Burn the Ballroom. One day, he brought his electric guitar into class and started playing different tunes to what they were learning. He also played a song he wrote called Fire Breather for the class. He was the best and coolest teacher Taleb ever had. Number 4 was submitted by Tech and Girl 105. There was one teacher that Dolan had who did a lot of amazing things for his students. But one time in particular, he saw that all of his game designer students were feeling under the weather. So he had the class pass around 7 USBs. All of these contained Unreal Tournament 3, and after every computer was finished downloading the game, Dolan and his classmates spent the rest of the class laughing and
playfully shouting at each other while playing together. After that day, every time the class was around as well, Donald's teacher betrayal would stand up and say, "You all have 5 minutes to finish working and send in progress for playing video games today." Sadly, due to our strict and old fashioned the high school life, he ended up quitting. Donald's teacher treated his students as actual people with actual lives outside of school, and he had a massive success rate for his classes. The most debatable submitted by Flora Descent. When Sacred Snoopy was in 6th grade, there was a bullying endeavor. He initially stole things from people, harassed girls, and started fights. One day, Sacred Snoopy and her classmates social studies, and her teacher was writing on the board. Adamant was having an argument with another student about shoes because they were not important to him. So when the teacher was done with the useless arguing, she turned around and asked what was so important that they had to interrupt the lesson. Adamant said the other student couldn't afford shoes, and he needed to point that out. Then Sacred Snoopy's teacher said to him, "Well, you can't afford soap, but no one else is complaining." Sacred Snoopy's pretty sure she saw that kid down, and everyone was pretty much screaming as her teacher turned around and continued with the lesson. Number 2 was submitted by Wolfman Thomas. Once we commando had a substitute teacher in senior year for government class who was in the army, and two of his classmates who were in a relationship got into a fight with a boy threatening his girlfriend right in front of the sub. The sub quickly got involved. The asshole Romeo dropped back at the teacher who replied, "How about you shut the fuck up?" and escorted the asshole to the principal's office. Needless to say, everyone in class wanted to get on his good side after that. Number 1 was submitted by me. So in the 9th grade, me and my friend had a creative writings class with a teacher named Mr. Cooper. Mr. Cooper was the coolest guy. He was so chilly down there, and we could talk to him about anything. All he had us do in class was write a poem, and then basically take the entire class off. We only had 8 students in the class, which made it even more fun. Eventually, he had to actually give us work, and since we were used to not doing work, a lot of the students in the class didn't listen to him. And he lost his temper and became unsure really fast, but I never looked down on him for it. He used to do his job. He was really a cool guy. I had a deal with him once when he was a ruler of a planet named Kings with Big Earth. And his name was Coop Nasty, and so me and my friends started calling him Coop Nasty, and he totally just went along with it. He had no idea what we were talking about. He and I spotted the Coop Nasty for a very long time, and even after we didn't have this class anymore, we would go by and say hi and talk to him, and yeah, he was a pretty cool guy. I kinda miss him. I wonder what he's up to these days. Huge thanks to the folks over the Planet Dawn subreddit for submitting their stories. We have another question for you. What was the most disturbing thing that's ever happened to you on a bus? Let us know in the Reddit page link below, and you might be featured in a future countdown. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you soon.
He's being taken to a sex specialist, but he's also somehow being mixed up with someone else's, and the story was taken.